sunny. Yesterday my life was filled with rain, sunny. You smiled at me and really eased the pain. Now the dark days are done and the bright days are here. My sunny one shines so sincere. Sunny one so true, I love you.
All right, it's the day before Memorial Day. Kind of give a little solar update here. Got a pretty hot day, about 80 degrees or 90 degrees almost going to today. You can see our trees have filled out quite a bit since early spring. We used to have the sun like right up here, but here it is now, almost directly overhead. So I got the solar tracker pointing in that direction. And the main panels, nothing's changed there, but you can see my tree to the east is all filled out. The sun actually comes up right over top of here in the morning. So let's go check the wall, see how the power's doing. All right, if you remember my box here, I got my TriMetric 2020. It's reading right now the battery voltage. I can switch it to amps. So right now I'm bringing in about 36 amps into my batteries from all the solar. I've got all my switches marked up. So that's saying I'm charging my batteries. And the reason I'm doing that because we've had gray. The last few days have been pretty gray. And my batteries are down to 45% charged. So we're trying to bring those up. I looked down at my Windy Nation meter here. You can see this is the watts coming in, 460 watts of my 550 watts or so panels. It's going over to my charge controller. The top reading here is reading the voltage of the charge controller, or of the panels themselves, so 14.1 maximum power point is where it's locked in right now. And the battery voltage 13.6. I can change this to solar current or charging current, 33, 34. Oh, excuse me, that's the solar panel current. And then here's the charge current, 32.8. Now if I switch these all over to the grid tie for a second, all my grid tie converters will start to come up. So I've got my solar tracker here starting to warm up. See how close it gets. I think it gets probably like 80 or so, maybe a little bit more today. There we go, 82. My 65 is at 45. We're at a little bit of high thin clouds. About 90, 85, 90 on my larger panels. And then total, about 450. All right, so if I go back to the solar charging, I got it on amps here. So this is the amps that I'm bringing in and charging my batteries with. Here's my inverter here, and I just temporarily shut it off. It's running the house refrigerator, so let me turn it on. That's the only load it has on, and you can see what it's going to do to the amps. Turn it on. Initially gets a big spike. And even though we're still bringing 35 in, so this is what I have coming in, and this is what is the net balance. So we got about 36 coming in, 23 balance. So it says that as I'm running the refrigerator, it's about 12 to 13 amps going through this 800 watt pure sine wave inverter. I've had this setup working basically since the early part of March. I've not had to touch anything. I do occasionally come out, and if the batteries are all charged up, I'll put more back into the grid to balance things out. So let me show you how I do that. All right, so I got my TED meter telling me the house right now is using 114 watts. So now it's a matter of just selecting some of these grid tie inverters to get up to 114. Let's turn on the tracker. So that'll give us about a cloud. It'll give us around 80 or so. See where it comes up here. All right, we'll go back to the TED. That dropped it down to 34. So my other choice here is my 65er. I'll turn that one on. All right, that's 45. So that what that is, it actually ran it beyond zero. So now I'm putting 32x's into the grid. Let's try a different combination. Well, see, that's about 10. That's not too bad. I don't like to put any more in than I need to because I actually have to pay for any I put extra into the grid. So now I'm going to try the 80 and the 120. So I'll have the 80 come up here. We'll see what happens here. So it jumps up initially. Then as that one comes online, all right, that gets us down to 12. So that's 12 that we're drawing in from the line here. So my two options are putting a little extra in or running it down to about 12. So I think I'm going to keep on this situation here so I can have the rest going into my batteries. Batteries we're putting in about 29 amps now. See how the charge is coming up. All right, we're still at 45, so hopefully by the end of the day we'll get those batteries topped off and that'll get us through the night. All right, that's it for today. Catch you later. I love you.